Section 25 of The Art of Cookery Made Plain and Easy by Hannah Glasse. This LibriVox recording is in the public domain. Chapter 9, Part 7. For Lent or a Fast Dinner. From To Make a Fine Bread Pudding. Take all the crumb of a stale penny loaf, cut it thin, a quart of cream, set it over a slow fire till it is scalding hot, then let it stand till it is cold. Beat up the bread and cream well together, grate in some nutmeg, take 12 bitter almonds, boil them in 2 spoonfuls of water, pour the water to the cream and stir it in with a little salt. Sweeten to your palate, blanch the almonds and beat them in a mortar with 2 spoonfuls of rose or orange flower water till they are a fine paste. Then mix them by degrees with the cream till they are well mixed in the cream. Then take the yolks of 8 eggs, the whites of 4, beat them well and mix them with your cream. Then mix all well together. A wooden dish is best to boil it in, but if you boil it in a cloth, be sure to dip it in the hot water and flour it well, tie it loose and boil it an hour. Be sure the water boils when you put it in and keeps boiling all the time. When it is enough, turn it into your dish, melt butter and put in 2 or 3 spoonfuls of white wine or sack, give it a boil and pour it over your pudding. Then strew a good deal of fine sugar all over the pudding and dish, and send it to table hot. New milk will do when you cannot get cream. You may, for change, put in a few currants. To make an ordinary bread pudding. Take 2 halfpenny rolls, slice them thin, crust and all. Pour over them a pint of new milk boiling hot. Cover them close, let it stand some hours to soak. Then beat it well with a little melted butter, and beat up the yolks and whites of 2 eggs. Beat all together well with a little salt. Boil it half an hour. When it is done, turn it into your dish, pour melted butter and sugar over it. Some love a little vinegar in the butter. If your rolls are stale and grated, they will do better. Add a little ginger. You may bake it with a few currants. To make a baked bread pudding. Take the crumb of a penny loaf, as much flour, the yolks of 4 eggs and 2 whites, a teaspoonful of ginger, 1/2 pound of raisins stoned, 1/2 pound of currants clean washed and picked, a little salt. Mix first the bread and flour, ginger, salt and sugar to your palate, then the eggs, and as much milk as will make it like a good batter. Then the fruit, butter the dish, pour it in, and bake it. To make a boiled loaf. Take a penny loaf, pour over it 1/2 pint of milk boiling hot, cover it loose, let it stand till it has soaked up the milk. Then tie it up in a cloth and boil it 1/2 hour. When it is done, lay it in your dish, pour melted butter over it, and throw sugar all over. A spoonful of wine or rose water does as well in the butter, or juice of Seville orange. A French manchet does best, but there are little loaves made on purpose for the use. A French roll or oat cake does very well boiled thus. To make a chestnut pudding. Put 1½ dozen of chestnuts into a skillet or saucepan of water. Boil them 1/4 hour, then blanch and peel them, and beat them in a marble mortar with a little orange flower or rose water and sack, till they are a fine thin paste. Then beat up 12 eggs, with 1/2 the whites, and mix them well. Grate 1/2 a nutmeg, a little salt, mix them with 3 pints of cream and 1/2 pound of melted butter. Sweeten to your palate and mix all together. Put it over the fire and keep stirring it till it is thick. Lay a puff paste all over the dish. Pour in the mixture and bake it. When you cannot get cream, take 3 pints of milk, beat up the yolks of 4 eggs, and stir into the milk. Set it over the fire, stirring it all the time till it is scalding hot, then mix it in the room of the cream. To make a fine plain baked pudding. You must take a quart of milk and put 3 bay leaves into it. When it has boiled a little, with fine flour, make it into a hasty pudding with a little salt, pretty thick. Take it off the fire and stir in 1/2 pound of butter, 1/4 pound of sugar, beat up 12 eggs and 1/2 the whites. Stir all well together, lay a puff paste all over the dish and pour in your stuff. 1/2 hour will bake it. To make pretty little cheese curd puddings. You must take 1 gallon of milk and turn it with rennet, then drain all the curd from the whey, put the curd into a mortar and beat it with 1/2 pound of fresh butter till the butter and curd are well mixed. Then beat 6 eggs, 1/2 the whites, and strain them to the curd, 2 Naples biscuits, or 1/2 penny roll grated. Mix all these together and sweeten to your palate. Butter your patty pans and fill them with the ingredients. Bake them, but do not let your oven be too hot. When they are done, turn them out into a dish. Cut citron and candied orange peel into little narrow bits about 1 inch long, and blanched almonds cut in long slips. Stick them here and there on the tops of the puddings, just as you fancy. Pour melted butter with a little sack in it into the dish, and throw fine sugar all over the puddings and dish. They make a pretty side dish. To make an apricot pudding. Coddle 6 large apricots very tender. Break them very small. Sweeten them to your taste. When they are cold, add 6 eggs, only 2 whites, well beat. Mix them well together with 1 pint of good cream. Lay a puff paste all over your dish and pour in your ingredients. Bake it 1/2 hour. Do not let the oven be too hot. When it is enough, throw a little fine sugar all over it and send it to table hot. To make the Ipswich almond pudding. Steep somewhat above 3 ounces of the crumb of white bread sliced in 1.5 pints of cream, or grate the bread. Then beat 1/2 pint of blanched almonds very fine till they are like a paste, with a little orange flower water. Beat up the yolks of 8 eggs and the whites of 4. Mix all well together, put in 1/4 pound of white sugar, and stir in 1 little melted butter, about 1/4 pound. Put it over the fire and keep stirring it till it is thick. Lay a sheet of puff paste at the bottom of your dish and pour in the ingredients. 1/2 hour will bake it. Transparent pudding. Take 8 eggs and beat them well. Put them in a pan with 1/2 pound of fresh butter, 1/2 pound of fine powdered sugar, and 1/2 nutmeg grated. Set it on the fire and keep stirring it till it is of the thickness of buttered eggs. Then put it away to cool. Put a thin puff paste round the edge of your dish. Pour in the ingredients. Bake it 1/2 hour in a moderate oven and send it up hot. Puddings for little dishes. You must take 1 pint of cream and boil it and slit a 1/2-loaf and pour the cream hot over it, and cover it close till it is cold. Then beat it fine and grate in 1/2 large nutmeg, 1/4 pound of sugar, the yolks of 4 eggs, but 2 whites well beat. Beat it all well together. With 1/2 of this, fill 4 little wooden dishes. Colour 1 yellow with saffron, 1 red with cochineal, green with the juice of spinach, and blue with the syrup of violets. The rest mix with 1 ounce of sweet almonds blanched and beat fine, and fill a dish. Your dishes must be small, and tie your covers over very close with pack thread. When your pot boils, put them in. 1 hour will boil them. When enough, turn them out in a dish, the white one in the middle, and the four coloured ones round. When they are enough, melt some fresh butter with a glass of sack, and pour over, and throw sugar all over the dish. The white pudding dish must be of a larger size than the rest, and be sure to butter your dishes well before you put them in, and do not fill them too full. To make a sweetmeat pudding. Put a thin puff paste all over your dish, then have candied orange, lemon peel, and citron of each an ounce. Slice them thin and lay them all over the bottom of your dish. Then beat 8 yolks of eggs and 2 whites, near 1/2 pound of sugar and 1/2 pound of melted butter. Beat all well together. When the oven is ready, pour it on your sweetmeats, an hour or less will bake it. The oven must not be too hot. To make a fine plain pudding. Get a quart of milk, put into it 6 laurel leaves, boil it, then take out your leaves and stir in as much flour as will make it a hasty pudding pretty thick. Take it off and then stir in 1/2 pound of butter, then 1/4 pound of sugar, a small nutmeg grated, and 12 yolks and 6 whites of eggs well beaten. Mix all well together. Butter a dish and put in your stuff. A little more than 1/2 hour will bake it. To make a ratafia pudding. Get a quart of cream, boil it with 4 or 5 laurel leaves, then take them out and break in 1/2 pound of Naples biscuits, 1/2 pound of butter, some sack, nutmeg, and a little salt. Take it off the fire, cover it up. When it is almost cold, put in 2 ounces of blanched almonds beat fine, and the yolks of 5 eggs. Mix all well together and bake it in a moderate oven 1/2 hour. Scrape sugar on it as it goes into the oven. To make a bread and butter pudding. Get a penny loaf and cut it into thin slices of bread and butter as you do for tea. Butter your dish as you cut them. Lay slices all over the dish, then strew a few currants clean washed and picked, then a row of bread and butter, then a few currants, and so on till all your bread and butter is in. Then take a pint of milk, beat up 4 eggs, a little salt, 1/2 nutmeg grated. Mix all together with sugar to your taste. Pour this over the bread and bake it 1/2 hour. A puff paste under does best. You may put in 2 spoonfuls of rose water. To make a boiled rice pudding. Having got 1/4 pound of the flour of rice, put it over the fire with a pint of milk, and keep it stirring constantly that it may not clod nor burn. When it is of a good thickness, take it off and pour it into an earthen pan. Stir in 1/2 pound of butter very smooth, and 1/2 pint of cream or new milk. Sweeten to your palate. Grate in 1/2 nutmeg and the outward rind of a lemon. Beat up the yolks of 6 eggs and 2 whites. Beat all well together. Boil it either in small china basins or wooden bowls. When boiled, turn them into a dish, pour melted butter over them with a little sack, and throw sugar all over. To make a cheap rice pudding. Get 1/4 pound of rice and 1/2 pound of raisins stoned, and tie them in a cloth. Give the rice a great deal of room to swell. Boil it 2 hours. When it is enough, turn it into your dish and pour melted butter and sugar over it with a little nutmeg. To make a cheap, plain rice pudding. Get 1/4 pound of rice, tie it in a cloth, but give room for swelling. Boil it 1 hour, then take it up, untie it, and with a spoon stir in 1/4 pound of butter. Grate some nutmeg and sweeten to your taste. Then tie it up close and boil it 1 hour. Then take it up, turn it into your dish, and pour your melted butter over it. To make a cheap baked rice pudding. you must take a quarter of a pound of rice, boil it in a quart of new milk, stir it that it does not burn. When it begins to be thick, take it off, let it stand till it is a little cool, then stir in well a quarter of a pound of butter and sugar to your palate. Grate a small nutmeg, butter your dish, pour it in, and bake it. To make a spinach pudding. Take a quarter of a peck of spinach, picked and washed clean. Put it into a saucepan with a little salt, cover it close, and when it is boiled just tender, throw it into a sieve to drain. Then chop it with a knife, beat up 6 eggs, mix well with it 1/2 pint of cream, and a stale roll grated fine, a little nutmeg, and 1/4 pound of melted butter. Stir all well together. Put it into the saucepan you boiled the spinach, and keep stirring it all the time till it begins to thicken. Then wet and flour your cloth very well, tie it up, and boil it an hour. When it is enough, turn it into your dish, pour melted butter over it, and the juice of a Seville orange, if you like it. As to sugar, you may add, or let it alone, just to your taste. You may bake it, but then you should put in 1/4 pound of sugar. You may add biscuit in the room of bread, if you like it better. To make a quaking pudding. Take 1 pint of good cream, 6 eggs, and 1/2 the whites. Beat them well, and mix with the cream. Grate a little nutmeg in. Add a little salt and a little rose water, if it be agreeable. Grate in the crumb of a 1/2 roll, or a spoonful of flour, first mixed with a little of the cream, or a spoonful of the flour of rice, which you please. Butter a cloth well, and flour it, then put in your mixture, tie it not too close, and boil it 1/2 hour fast. Be sure the water boils before you put it in. To make a cream pudding. Take 1 quart of cream, boil it with a blade of mace and 1/2 nutmeg grated. Let it cool. Beat up 8 eggs and 3 whites, strain them well, mix a spoonful of flour with them, 1/4 pound of almonds blanched, and beat very fine. With a spoonful of orange flour or rose water, mix with the eggs, then by degrees mix in the cream. Beat all well together, take a thick cloth, wet it, and flour it well. Pour in your stuff, tie it close, and boil it 1/2 hour. Let the water boil all the time fast. When it is done, turn it into your dish, pour melted butter over with a little sack, and throw fine sugar all over it. To make a prune pudding. Take 1 quart of milk, beat 6 eggs, 1/2 the whites, with 1/2 pint of the milk, and 4 spoonfuls of flour, a little salt, and 2 spoonfuls of beaten ginger. Then by degrees, mix in all the milk and 1 pound of prunes, tie it in a cloth, boil it an hour, melt butter, and pour over it. Damsons eat well, done this way, in the room of prunes. To make a spoonful pudding. Take 1 spoonful of flour, 1 spoonful of cream or milk, an egg, a little nutmeg, ginger and salt. Mix all together and boil it in a little wooden dish 1/2 hour. You may add a few currants. To make an apple pudding. Make a good puff paste. Roll it out 1/2 inch thick. Pare your apples and core them, enough to fill the crust, and close it up. Tie it in a cloth and boil it. If a small pudding, 2 hours. If a large one, 3 or 4 hours. When it is enough, turn it into your dish, cut a piece of the crust out of the top, butter and sugar it to your palate. Lay on the crust again and send it to table hot. A pear pudding make the same way. And thus you may make a damson pudding, or any sort of plums, apricots, cherries, or mulberries, and are very fine. To make yeast dumplings. First make a light dough as for bread, with flour, water, salt, and yeast. Cover with a cloth and set it before the fire for half an hour. Then have a saucepan of water on the fire, and when it boils, take the dough and make it into little round balls as big as a large hen's egg. Then flat them with your hand and put them into the boiling water. A few minutes boils them. Take great care they do not fall to the bottom of the pot or saucepan, for then they will be heavy, and be sure to keep the water boiling all the time. When they are enough, take them up, which they will be in 10 minutes or less, lay them in your dish and have melted butter in a cup. As good a way as any to save trouble is to send to the baker's for half a quartern of dough, which will make a great many, and then you have only the trouble of boiling it. To make Norfolk dumplings. Mix a good thick batter, as for pancakes. Take half a pint of milk, 2 eggs, a little salt, and make it into a batter with flour. Have ready a clean saucepan of water boiling, into which drop this batter. Be sure the water boils fast, and 2 or 3 minutes will boil them. Then throw them into a sieve to drain the water away. Then turn them into a dish, and stir a lump of fresh butter into them. Eat them hot, and they are very good. To make hard dumplings. Mix flour and water with a little salt, like a paste. Roll them in balls as big as a turkey's egg. Roll them in a little flour, and have the water boiling. Throw them in the water, and half an hour will boil them. They are best boiled with a good piece of beef. You may add, for a change, a few currants. Have melted butter in a cup. Another way to make hard dumplings. Rub into your flour first a good piece of butter, then make it like a crust for a pie. Make them up and boil them as above. To make apple dumplings. Make a good puff paste, pare some large apples, cut them in quarters, and take out the cores very nicely. Take a piece of crust and roll it round, enough for one apple. If they are big, they will not look pretty, so roll a crust round each apple and make them round like a ball, with a little flour in your hand. Have a pot of water boiling, take a clean cloth, dip it in the water, and shake flour over it. Tie each dumpling by itself and put them in the water boiling, which keep boiling all the time. And if your crust is light and good, and the apples not too large, half an hour will boil them. But if the apples be large, they will take an hour's boiling. When they are enough, take them up and lay them in a dish. Throw fine sugar all over them and send them to table. Have good fresh butter melted in a cup, and fine beaten sugar in a saucer. Another way to make apple dumplings. Make a good puff paste crust, roll it out a little thicker than a crown piece. Pare some large apples and core them with an apple scoop. Fill the hole with beaten cinnamon, coarse or fine sugar, and lemon peel shred fine, and roll every apple in a piece of this paste. Tie them close in a cloth separate. Boil them an hour, cut a little piece of the top off, pour in some melted butter, and lay on your piece of crust again. Lay them in your dish, and throw fine sugar all over. Citron puddings. Take half a pint of cream, mix in it a spoonful of fine flour, 2 ounces of sugar, a little grated nutmeg, and the yolks of 3 eggs beat well. Put it in teacups and stick 2 ounces of citron cut very thin in it. Bake them in a quick oven and turn them out on a dish. To make a cheese curd florandine. Take 2 pounds of cheese curd, break it all to pieces with your hand, 1 pound of blanched almonds finely pounded with a little rose water, 1/2 pound of currants clean washed and picked, a little sugar to your palate, some stewed spinach cut small. Mix all well together, lay a puff paste in a dish, put in your ingredients, cover it with a thin crust, rolled and laid across, and bake it in a moderate oven half an hour. As to the top crust, lay it in what shape you please, either rolled or marked with an iron on purpose. A florindine of oranges or apples. Get half a dozen of Seville oranges, save the juice, take out the pulp, lay them in water 24 hours, shift them three or four times, then boil them in three or four waters, then drain them from the water. Put them in a pound of sugar and their juice. Boil them to a syrup. Take great care they do not stick to the pan you do them in, and set them by for use. When you use them, lay a puff paste all over the dish. Boil 10 pippins, pared, quartered and cored, in a little water and sugar, and slice two of the oranges, and mix with the pippins in the dish. Bake it in a slow oven, with crust as above. Or, just bake the crust, and lay in the ingredients. To make an artichoke pie. Boil 12 artichokes, take off all the leaves and choke, take the bottoms clear from the stalk. Make a good puff paste crust, and lay a quarter of a pound of good fresh butter all over the bottom of your pie. Then lay a row of artichokes, strew a little pepper, salt and beaten mace over them, then another row, and strew the rest of your spice over them. Put in a quarter of a pound more of butter in little bits. Take half an ounce of truffles and morels, boil them in a quarter of a pint of water, pour the water into the pie, cut the truffles and morels very small, throw all over the pie, then have ready 12 eggs boiled hard. Take only the hard yolks, lay them all over the pie, pour in a gill of white wine, cover your pie, and bake it. When the crust is done, the pie is enough. 4 large blades of mace and 12 peppercorns well beat will do, with a teaspoonful of salt. To make a sweet egg pie. Make a good crust, cover your dish with it, then have ready 12 eggs boiled hard. Cut them in slices and lay them in your pie. Throw half a pound of currants, clean washed and picked, all over the eggs. Then beat up 4 eggs well, mix with half a pint of white wine, grate in a small nutmeg, and make it pretty sweet with sugar. You are to mind to lay a quarter of a pound of butter between the eggs, then pour in your wine and eggs, and cover your pie. Bake it half an hour, or till the crust is done. To make a potato pie. Boil 3 pounds of potatoes, peel them, make a good crust, and lay in your dish. Lay at the bottom half a pound of butter, then lay in your potatoes, throw over them 3 teaspoonfuls of salt, and a small nutmeg grated all over, 6 eggs boiled hard and chopped fine, throw all over, a teaspoonful of pepper strewed all over, then half a pint of white wine. Cover your pie and bake it half an hour, or till the crust is enough. End of section 25.